This is the Lockpicking Lawyer, and welcome to the 10th and final episode of the Naughty Bucket Chronicles. Today we're going to talk about the locks that got away. And I have to say that the two locks left standing after this series are a complete surprise to me. That's because I have opened many similar locks in the past without any significant difficulty. But there is obviously something very different about these two locks that make them much, much harder. So, without further ado, lock number one is this 2-bar T-handled core. The name 2-bar references the two sidebars and 8 sliders that you will find inside of this mechanism, and both Bill and I have opened locks like this in the past. In fact, after I was unable to open this one, I took out the 3 2-bars that I have remaining in my collection. I used to have a lot more and gave them away, and I was able to open these without any trouble. However, on this one, I spent about an hour a day for 3 days straight trying to open it, and I have nothing to show for my efforts. I have no idea why this one is so much harder than the others I've tried, but I do know that when this returns to the Naughty Bucket, it deserves a seat of honor. Next, we have this Zeta padlock. And again, I have opened this other Zeta padlock with an identical core without any trouble at all. However, on this one, when I apply tension to the core, something inside seizes up and I can't pick it. Now, unlike the 2-bar, this one didn't completely shut me out. In about 3 hours, I did open it once, but I don't think that qualifies as an eviction, particularly because it wasn't on camera. So I actually tore these two locks apart and compared every little component in their two cores, and I can't figure out why this one is so easy to open, and this one I can't open at all, at least not on demand. So again, this one is going back to the Naughty Bucket with its dignity intact. So, of the 11 locks that I chose from Bill's Naughty Bucket, these are the two that are returning undefeated. I wanted to conclude with a couple of thoughts on this series, and in particular, why I've had some success against these locks. First, and I think most importantly, this is not a random group of locks. I selected the locks that played to my strengths as a picker. So, while I opened 80% of the locks that I chose, chances are that my success rate would be dramatically lower with other Naughty Bucket locks. Second, before I touched any one of these locks, I actually had a great deal of information about picking them. You see, I have watched several hundred of Bill's videos, and because of that, I know very well his approach to tension, picking, and pick selection. And I also know that none of it worked for these locks. So, while Bill didn't open them, that doesn't mean that I didn't benefit from his efforts. Because I knew Bill didn't open them, I knew what not to do, and that's more important than you may think. Third, Bill and I have very different picking styles. Bill tends to favor a light and deft touch, while I've had a little bit more success applying a heavy hand. Because different locks tend to respond better to different picking styles, it follows that the locks that didn't respond well to Bill's style probably would respond better to mine. Fourth and last, none of these were blind picks. When you saw me picking, I had already opened the locks and I knew what worked. So in sum, in shooting these videos in the Naughty Bucket Chronicle series, I had every possible advantage from the very beginning. I mention this because this series was Bill's idea. And proving the axiom that no good deed goes unpunished, I've seen a few comments that say that this series is a reflection of our comparative skill, and I don't think that's accurate at all. The truth is that I had every possible advantage, and this series reflects that. Bill could have just as easily selected for me the most dastardly locks in the bucket, and this series would have been stillborn. So, I want to close by thanking Bill for allowing me this shot at the Naughty Bucket. It was a ton of fun for me. To everyone else, I have a homework assignment for you. I'd like you to give some thought to what you'd like to see in a future collaboration between Bill and I. And if you have any good ideas, go ahead and put them in the comments below. But that's it for today. If you have any other comments, please put them below. If you like this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe. And as always, have a nice day. Thank you.